Melbourne businesses have been thrown a taxpayer-funded lifeline. Treasurer Tim Pallas announcing $500 million of support. Stephanie Anderson is on Brunswick Street in Fitzroy. Now, Steph, how far will the money go?
Well, Pete, the state government is hopeful that at least 80,000 businesses are going to benefit from a one-off $5,000 grant that it'll start rolling out on Monday. Now, some say that won't go far, but others say something is better than nothing under these conditions. And you can really see the conditions around me tonight. I'm on Brunswick Street on a Friday evening. It would normally be chock-a-block. Tonight, it's just delivery drivers, a few people going for a walk, and those picking up their takeaway. And the same effect is being felt by thousands across the lockdown zone. Normally packed with kids' parties and school holiday crowds, this mini city in Malvern is now a ghost town.
It's heartbreaking. This place is filled with love and laughter and children running around, bouncing off each other and their parents, having a great time with them, and today it's just complete silence.
With thousands of businesses struggling under the weight of the second wave of restrictions, the state government stumped up $534 million of support.
The pain, for the hardship that people have to endure, I want to be very clear that the government apologises to Victorians for it.
The package includes $30 million to assist crippled nighttime operators, including restaurants and bars, $26 million for mental health support for small business owners, $10 million for mentoring, and close to $400 million to the fund paying $5,000 grants to businesses in the lockdown zone if they're registered for JobKeeper and have a payroll of less than $3 million a year.
For 6 weeks of trading with absolutely zero revenue, that does not touch the side for us.
Overall is a drop in the ocean, really, but at this stage I'm going to say anything's helpful.
Far too little, and there are far too many businesses who are going to fall through the cracks here.
The Yarra Valley Chocolatiery and Ice Creamery is one of the venues falling through the cracks. It's in the lockdown zone, but too big to qualify for much of the cash, even though revenue has fallen by as much as 95% and half its staff are out of work.
If we, you know, don't have some help, we're just not going to be here in a few weeks' time.
The state government says this won't be where the support stops for those struggling over the next 6 weeks. The Treasurer is keeping a close eye on the future of JobKeeper payments, with the Commonwealth due to make further announcements on July 23.
It's not meant to fix all the problems, but it will certainly make a difference to cash flow for these businesses and give them some hope of getting back through the other end.
Stephanie Anderson, Nine News.